Creating eyebrows with Ornatrix for Maya is now extremely easy with the Eyebrow Graft Groom, available as of version 4. Once you have a humanoid character, first thing I'll do is press on the Create Graft Groom button and open the Tools window. Here I will select the eyebrow graft surface and the common eyebrow graft groom, and then I will just click and drag on top of my model to define the eyebrow area. It is okay if you don't get it completely right at first. You can always select these fit handles and you can readjust the position of the graft surface at any point. Additionally, you can select groups of vertices. For example, here I can select this edge and you can move them individually with optional soft selection strength, and you can adjust those. You can also rotate and scale these parts on top of your model. And you can also just grab individual vertices and you can also move just the individual parts of the graft surface. At any point, you can also go back to the fit handles and you can move those to adjust the overall shape of your graft surface. So I will roughly define the place where my eyebrow area is on my character. And as you can see, the eyebrow itself is automatically generated. I want to be able to also get the same eyebrow on the other side of my character, and to do this I will go to the attribute editor and find this mirror groom enable option in the settings. I will press the enable button, and here the axis is X by default, but you can change it to Y or Z if your character is oriented differently. And when I do that, you can see that the groom is mirrored to the other side of my character. So if I look at the actual operator stack, you can see that I have a single groom operator, and inside this groom operator is where I find all these parameters that are specific to eyebrow settings of my character. Let's go through this one by one and see what they do. So the first option is the hair count. Here you can increase or decrease the density of our hairs, as well as just change the preview density that's displayed inside the viewport versus the render options. Then I have the inner fullness. The fullness parameters allow you to control how full the hair is at different parts of your eyebrow. So here I have the inner side of my eyebrow, but also I can control the fullness at the outer side of my eyebrow. So you can really define how thick you want the eyebrows to be towards the middle or towards the side of your character. So next option is the inner direction, and here we can change the direction where the hairs are pointing on the inner side of my eyebrow. Likewise, we can also do the middle direction. Here we control where the hair is pointing in the middle of my eyebrow and the outer direction of my eyebrow. Here we control where the eyebrow points on the side of my character's face. So the next option is the inner length. Here we control the length of the eyebrows. Again, we can control this in the inner side of the eyebrow, and we can control this in the middle of the eyebrow, and the outer length as well. And these are defined separately, so you can adjust the eyebrow shape exactly to what you want. So the next option is the flow. We have this flow available in the middle and the side portions of the character. So the flow basically defines how the hairs are sticking together or are kind of flowing apart. You can create bushy eyebrows, or you can make them really neat by increasing the flow parameter. So again, I have the same parameter to the outer side of my eyebrow. I can make it really bushy here, or I can pull it all together to make sure that they're flowing together. Next option is the messiness. Here is just where I can mess up the directions of our hair. And especially for the longer eyebrow hairs, you might want to make them really messy in some cases. Then I can also increase the randomness of the length. By default, eyebrows don't really have a lot of randomization in the length, but you can adjust the setting to fit your specific need. And we have the root flare and the tip flare options. And the flare basically defines, if I look at the top of my character here, the flare defines how much the eyebrows are sticking to the surface. This is at the root of the eyebrow, and then we have also at the tip of the eyebrow. You can see the setting being changed here, and it's changing how the hairs are flaring in and out of the eyebrow. Then we also have the thickness parameter. I can make my eyebrows thicker by changing the thickness of individual hairs, and I can also vary the thickness along the surface. This cut thickness parameter basically allows you to make sure that the thickness is not absolute and only the longest of the hairs gets the tapered effect and the rest of them are kind of cut relative to the longest hair. Next we have the detail parameter, and this defines how many points we have per each strand on the eyebrow. So the lowest parameter is 2, where we just have 2 points per eyebrow, or we can increase it to a higher setting to get more details. Finally, we have the random seed parameter, and this basically allows you to randomize this eyebrow. Note that we also have this randomize parameter over here, and if I turn it off, then the eyebrows are going to be identical on each side of the character, so you can see that the shape is mirrored exactly to the other side. But if I check this option, then we get the mirrored eyebrow to be different from the original eyebrow. Even if I change the random seed, you can see that the opposite eyebrow is always going to be different from the original one, just the way it happens in nature. So once I have specified the shapes of my eyebrows, they will stick to the surface, but they will stick to the graft surfaces, which are those initial meshes that we fitted on top of our character's face. And that is fine because they will deform with your character. However, if you want the hairs of the eyebrows to actually be exactly sticking on top of the character's face, you may want to add a ground strands operator. And after adding this, just press attach roots option, and the eyebrows are going to be growing exactly from the mesh of your character. After this, you can do anything else you do with Ornatrix Groom. For example, I can go and further adjust the shape of my eyebrows. So you see the changes I made here with edit guides. Or I can apply any other operator from Ornatrix to further refine the shape. So this demonstrates the power of using graft grooms in Ornatrix to apply procedural predefined grooms to save you a lot of time and energy, as well as to make it fun creating facial hair for your characters.